Hello friends, welcome to my channel JM Learning. Today we are going to learn LED lighting projector part 2 under our course Illumination and Electrification of Building. For better understanding of this video, you can refer to my previous video, that is part 1 of LED lighting projector. Before we discuss how to calculate the number of LED lighting projector required for a given building surface or premises, let us first understand the basic terms that are associated with LED lighting. First definition is of beam factor. It is defined as the ratio of total lumens in the beam of projector to the total lumens given out by lamp. For better understanding, please refer to this figure. Here we are having the lamp fitted in projector. The output of the lamp in the form of the light rays will be coming out from this surface. So whatever the lumens that are being coming out from the projector surface, if we divide it by the lumens produced by the lamp, then it gives the beam factor. Beam factor can be termed as the how much is the efficient projector and its internal surfaces. Second most important factor to be considered while calculating number of LED lighting projector is the waste light factor. Waste light factor is being associated with this LED lighting design because we require the number of projector to illuminate a given surface. In such cases, there will be a certain overlapping of the various light rays or circles produced by the different projectors. So to consider that wastage of the light due to overlapping of the light rays, when we have to illuminate a given surface, we have to consider the waste light factor. It will depend upon the number of projector, the situation of the surface, the distance of the projector from the surface to be illuminated. The third important factor is the coefficient of utilization. It is defined as the ratio of total number of lumens reaching the working plane to the total number of lumens emitting from the source. As projector is placed at a certain distance from the surface to be illuminated, so whatever lumens produced by that projector as a source, not all will reach the working plane. Some will be lost in the medium that it has to travel. So that considering whatever the lumens that being lost, we have to consider the utilization factor for the LED lighting projector calculation. The fourth important term is the depreciation factor. Depreciation factor is defined as the ratio of illumination when everything is clean to the illumination under normal operating conditions. Whenever a surface is to be illuminated at first initial time, the situation will be most clean and healthy for lighting design. But as the time passes, the illumination on the same surface will go on reducing. So considering that, depreciation factor has to be taken into account. The fifth factor, that is the reflection factor. It is the ratio of the luminous flux being reflected or leaving from the surface to the luminous flux incident on it. This factor is going to depend upon the type of surface, its quality and the color given to that particular surface, because in flood lighting the surface is going to reflect the whatever the light rays falling on it, and depending upon it, reflection factor has to be decided considering this situation. Then the important factor associated with the lamp is the lamp efficiency. The lamp efficiency defined as the ratio of the light output to the electrical power input of lamp. As the light output we are going to measure in lumens, power input is watt. So lamp efficiency will be expressed in the lumens per watt. Now let us see how to calculate the number of LED light projector for a given surface to be illuminated. The equation for it will be given by capital N, where N will stand for number of LED light projector. This term to calculate, we are having the denominator and numerator. The numerator will have the four terms, that is the illumination level, then the area, waste light factor and the depreciation factor, while the denominator will have the three terms, that is the wattage of each lamp to be used in projector, efficiency of the lamp and multiplied by the utilization factors. So considering all these seven terms, we can calculate the number of projector to be required for the given surface to be illuminated. Now how to apply this equation to get the number of floodlighting projector? Let us see one of the numerical. So the problem statement is, a building of 50 meter into 15 meter is to be illuminated by floodlight projectors which are situated 25 meter away from that particular surface or building. If the illumination level is 100 lux, the coefficient of utilization is 0.5, the depreciation factor is 1.5, the waste light factor is 1.2, then estimate the number, size and angle of projectors, assuming that the projector contain 1000 watt lamp having the 17 lumens per watt as the luminous efficiency. So before we solve this problem, let us first write the given data. So first given data is the luminous illumination level, that is 100 lux, then the area of working plane, that is given to us as 15 into 15, that is 750 square meter, then utilization factor is given as 0.5, depreciation factor is given as 1.5, the waste light factor is being given as 1.2, the lamp to be used are having wattage of 1000 watt, each lamp is having efficiency of 17 lumens per watt. The distance of projector from the building is to be considered as 25 meter. Considering all this, now we can use the equation to calculate the number of projectors. Putting the value of whatever the data we have just seen in the equation, we will get the number of projector coming out as 15.88. So that will be equated to next integer, that is the 16. So for the given situation, that is for 750 square meter surface area, illumination level is 100 lux, the given UF, DF and other parameters, we require the number of projectors for that building surface as the 16 number. Now let us see the calculation of the size and angle of spread required for this given flood lighting building surface to be illuminated. So in considering size of projector, first we have to remember that we have to get a uniform illumination on the given surface. The uniform illumination we can obtain only by overlapping of the different illuminated circles produced by the different projector. Each projector is going to produce one circle on the surface. If these circles are overlap, then only we will be able to have a uniform illumination. Now just we calculated that there will be 16 number of projector required for the illuminating this building surface having the length of 50 meter and width of 15 meter. It means that we can divide that projectors as lengthwise we can take 8 projectors and widthwise we can have 2 projectors. So the projector will produce the 8 circles lengthwise and 2 circles widthwise. They will be overlapping each other. For better uniform illumination, the total overlapping distance will be of 3 meter, 1 meter at top, 1 meter at middle, 1 meter at the bottom side. So we will have the circle diameter as the 9 meter for each projector circle. Now let us see how we can get that beam angle or angle of projector. For that we have to consider this particular diagram. This diagram represents at this end the projector is being fitted. The right side gives the building surface. This building surface, whatever we can observe, is having a circle. The circle will have a diameter of 9 meters. So radius of circle will be of 4.5 meter. This 4.5 meter circle is away from the projector at a distance of 25 meter as given to us. So whatever that circle total diameter will have an angle with the projector as theta, it will be divided as theta by 2 equally at its center point. As the diameter is 9 meter, the radius will be 4.5 meter. So tan of theta 2, if we can take, then tan of theta 2 will be equal to 4.5 meter by divided by 25 meter. So if we multiply this theta 2 into 2, will get the theta. So this equation come here as angle of spread theta is equal to 2 into tan inverse. As we have to calculate here the angle, we have to take the tan inverse of 4.5 by 25, and we get the answer as 20 degree. That means theta by 2 will be of 10 degree h. So the angle of spread or angle to be required for the projector in the form of the beam will be of 20 degree. So the right solution for this given problem is we require 16 number of projectors. Each projector will have the lamp of 1000 watt as power input, and it has to have a beam angle of 20 degree to get the uniform illumination on this building surface, where the illumination level required is 100 lumens. So likewise, you can solve the more numericals on calculation of number of floodlight projectors for the given building surface to be illuminated. With this, I am sure that you got the idea of understanding of the different terms that are being used in floodlighting projector design calculations, and how to calculate the number of flood lighting projectors. Thanks for watching this video. Do like it and share it.